The interview questions that I have for you today is, how do you handle conflict? Now, what employers are trying to see is, do you walk away from conflict? Do you hide behind the scene and just, you know, come after when the conflict is done? How do you handle the conflict? Well, it's a normal life. Everyone's gonna have to go through the situations. What matters is, how do you handle it? So what I would do is I would answer, conflicts are great. Imagine we are working with the same type of people, same type of personality. It's gonna be boring. So when someone is disagreeing and there's a conflict, there's a differences, I want to understand their perspective. What are they thinking? Maybe I am not thinking the way that they are thinking. When you are presenting your idea, for example, and someone disagrees, don't shut them down. Invite them. That's what I do. When the conflict happens, when someone's saying, that's what, I don't think it's gonna work, you know what I'm gonna ask them is, oh, okay, tell me more. I never thought about it. Tell me more. So here's what I'm doing. The way I handle it is, I am open to listening. I am open to actually work together and collaborate together. Maybe I missed some point on my presentations, on my idea, that the person thinks that, you know what, they need to add some materials on it. I'm okay with that. It's a teamwork. So that's how I handle conflict. I invite people, I'm very receptive, and I'm willing to work with them. The way that I work on a conflict is, whenever there's a conflict, I am listening to understand. I am seeking for that information on why. So always working through together in a team, conflict is not something we cannot resolve. And there's gonna be some time that you're gonna have to walk out of it. You have to involve someone else as well. And fortunately, I have not had that happen. So this is how you are going to close it. You're not going to say, I've never had conflict. That means that employer's gonna think that, I don't think it's gonna work out, right? And imagine your job is all about negotiation. Your job is all about process improvement. You have to go to different route. You have to go and reach out to the stakeholder to understand, and there's gonna be a lot of conflict. So if you're one of those who cannot handle conflict, then you know what? It's gonna be very hard sell for you an interview. So when people are asking about, how do you resolve the conflict? They're not looking at resolving the conflict. What they're looking at is, how do you handle? How are you dealing with the relationship? Short term, long term, do you communicate? They're looking at the communication style. Are you one of those who's gonna say my way or highway? They're looking at a bunch of information. How are you going to bring along the people on the same table that they've disagreed? What's your secret? And that's what they wanna know. You don't have to resolve the conflict. Some conflicts you cannot resolve at all. And sometimes you just have to give up and just, you know, escalate further. Or sometimes you have to do things that, you know, that you don't want to do. On a leadership role, like, you know, sometimes it's hard. You might have to fire people because there's a lot of conflict that you cannot solve together. You have to involve HR. So depending on the conflict, but again, at the same time, the moral of the story when it comes to conflict is, how do you communicate? How do you bring other people? How do you seek the informations? And how do you resolve that? Or how do you escalate? Do you take initiative when it comes to conflict? Do you try to avoid it? Do you try to wait until last minute, until the things get worse? So number one, when it comes to conflict, is just be there on a moment and attack it right away. Don't wait until last minute. And that's what it is. It has to be in a timely manner before it gets escalated, before it becomes very worse. And that's what they were trying to find out. What do you do? And how do you handle it? And how do you involve the people in the team? How do you work in a team when there's a conflict? There is nothing to stress about it. You can just talk about conflict and say, conflicts are really good because it brings good idea, it brings innovations, and it's a part of being a team. It's not bad. Conflicts are not bad. It helps you think. That's what you're gonna tell interviewer, and you are going to pass this interview. All right. And if you have any questions about how do you do the interviews, we do live interview sessions. You can contact us through social media pages on Teach and Do.